In this class, we will discuss what is quadratic chain and what are the different inversions of quadratic chain. First, we will discuss what is quadratic chain. Quadratic chain is any four links kinematic chain. In this quadratic chain, there are four links. In this, four bar chain is a quadratic chain. A four bar mechanism is a mechanism having four rigid links with one link fixed. This is a quadratic chain. Okay, this is a four bar mechanism. It is having four rigid links and one link is fixed. This figure shows that four bar mechanism. This quadratic chain consists of four turning pegs. Here in this figure, it consists of four turning pegs. Here there are four links. One is the frame, other one is the crank, coupler and the rocker. The fixed link, we call it as a frame, and one of the rotating link, we call it as a crank, or it is also called as a driver. Okay, crank we will call it as a driver and the rocker we will call it as a driven. The other rotating link is called the follower or the rocker. This one we call it as a rocker. And here this coupler we call it as a floating link. Floating link means it is not connected to the frame or the fixed link. That we call it as a floating link. Or this floating link we call that as a coupler or a connecting rod. Depending upon the arrangement and the proportions of the links, the two pivoted links may both rotate through 360 degree. One may rotate through 360 degree while the other oscillates, or both may oscillate. In this four bar mechanism, it is possible to have two links completely rotates, or one link completely rotates and other will oscillate, or both the links may oscillate. And it is possible to have different inversions. Okay, last class we have discussed what is an inversion. It is possible to have the different inversions by fixing the different, changing the fixedness of the link in a mechanism. If I fix the first, okay, let me call this as 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 links. If I fix the first one, we call it as a first inversion. If I fix the second link, we call it as a second inversion. Or if we fix the third link, we call it as a third inversion. Or if we fix the fourth link, we call it as a fourth inversion. And here it is possible to have the four inversions. And last class we have discussed the number of inversions in the mechanism is equal to the number of links in the mechanism. Okay, that is the property of the inversions. Okay, here we will discuss some of the inversions of a four bar chain. Okay, they are coupling rod of a locomotive or coupling wheel of a locomotive. This is one of the inversion of a four bar chain or the four bar mechanism. Then beam engine, then Watt's straight line mechanism. Okay, now we will discuss one by one. Here, this is the coupling wheel of a locomotive. Here, in this coupling wheel of a locomotive, these two links, there are four links in this mechanism, link 1, 2, 3, 4. And these two are parallel to each other, link 1 and link 3. They are equal, AB is equal to CD. And also these are parallel to each other. Here AD is equal to BC, and also they are parallel to each other. This is one of the example, one of the inversion of a four bar mechanism. Okay, this is a parallel chain mechanism. Okay, that is a parallel chain mechanism, or it is a coupled wheel of of a locomotive or coupling rod of a locomotive. And you might have seen this type of mechanism, okay, in trains. I think you might have seen this in the trains, this mechanism, coupled wheel of a locomotive. Or it is also called as parallel link mechanism. These two are parallel to each other, link 1 and link 3, and also they are equal. AD is equal to BC, and also they are parallel to each other. Okay, this is the animation of that coupled wheel of a locomotive. Okay, here it transmits the rotary motion from this wheel to this wheel, wheel 1 to wheel 2. Okay, it will transmit the motion from here to here through this coupling rod. Next, we will discuss beam engine. This shows that beam engine. What is this beam engine? Here, in the beam engine, this is also called as a lever crank mechanism. This beam engine is also called as a lever crank mechanism, where the crank rotates about the fixed center. This is a fixed center. Here, this is the fixed center. Here, the crank rotates about the fixed center and the rocker oscillates. This is the rocker. Crank rotates, this rocker oscillates. This is the crank rocker mechanism. Okay. This is crank, one link is rotating and other is oscillating. And this is the lever crank. Okay, that this we call it as a lever crank mechanism. And here, this is the fixed center. Okay, if we call this as the crank as AB, and that turns about the fixed center. And if I consider this, this is a lever and this is a rocker. Okay, when the crank rotates, that lever, that it will oscillate, that lever will oscillate, and this is the piston which is connected to that lever, oscillates inside this cylinder. This is one of the inversion of a 4-bar chain. This is a double crank mechanism. Here the two links are completely rotating. Okay, this is the double crank mechanism. Two links are completely rotating. This is a coupled wheel of a coupling rod of a locomotive, is a double crank mechanism, and this is a crank rocker mechanism. One link will completely rotate and other will oscillate. Double crank mechanism, crank rocker mechanism. And it is possible to have one more mechanism, that is called rocker rocker mechanism. Okay, here no link will completely rotate. Okay, they will oscillate. Okay, both the links will oscillate. That is called the rocker rocker mechanism. This is the one of the example inversion of the 4-bar chain, that Watt straight line mechanism. This is the Watt straight line mechanism. This shows that. And this is an example of double lever mechanism. Okay, this is called the double rocker mechanism or double lever mechanism. This is the double crank mechanism. This is the double rocker mechanism. This is the crank rocker mechanism. Okay, in the 4-bar mechanism, it is possible to have the different inversions. Okay, one is the crank mechanism or the double crank mechanism. Other one is the crank rocker mechanism. One link will completely rotate and other will oscillate. And this is the other third inversion. Here it is possible to have double rocker mechanism. Okay, or double lever mechanism, where both the pivoted links can only oscillate. This link and this link, these two are the pivoted links, will oscillate. Both the links will oscillate about the fixed center. Okay, this is a fixed center. This one and this one are the fixed centers, and they are oscillating about this fixed centers. And here, the links, these two links. Okay, let me consider this as A, link A, or this is the point A, B, C, D. Okay, let me name this as A, B, C, D. And this A, B and C, D oscillate about the fixed center A and D. Okay, this will oscillate about the fixed center. Okay, let me write this. Here, this I'll call it as A, and this is D. This one I'll call it as B, and this is C. And here these A and D are the fixed center, and it is pivoted at this point, and it will trace a path of figure 8 that shaped the figure 8. It will trace a path, and the tracing point is at the center of this link. Okay, the tracing point is at the center of this link. Okay, this will show that animation, how it will trace a path of 8, that figure 8 shaped path. Okay, this will show that figure 8 shaped path. Next, we will discuss now inversions of single slider crank mechanism. Okay, here if any one of the link in a 4-bar mechanism is, we have already discussed that 4-bar mechanism is having 4 turning pairs. If any one of the kinematic pair or link is replaced by a sliding pair, any one of the kinematic pair is replaced by a sliding pair, then we will call it as an inversion of a single slider crank mechanism, or we call it as a single slider. Here it is a slider. In place of that binary link, we have a slider here. And what are the different inversions of a single slider crank mechanism? Now it is possible to have 4 inversions. Okay, number of inversions in a mechanism is equal to the number of links that we have already discussed in the last class. Now it is possible to have 4 inversions. Okay, can depends on the link which we are fixing. We call that name first inversion, second inversion, third inversion and fourth inversion. Okay, here we will consider the single slider crank mechanism. The example, it is a reciprocating engine. Okay, this is the example for single slider crank mechanism. Okay, here in this, if it is a reciprocating engine, piston is a driver and this is a driven. That crank is a driven, piston is a driver. If it is a reciprocating compressor, this piston is a driven and this is a crank is a driver. Okay, there are 4 links, and what are all those 4 links in this single slider crank mechanism? The cylinder is one link, piston is other link, connecting rod is one link, and the crank is other link. Okay, there are 4 links in this single slider crank mechanism. Here we have written that link 1 is a fixed link, then the slider, connecting rod and the crank. Okay, if it is a reciprocating engine, the piston is a driver and this will crank is a connecting, is a crank is a driven. This is the first inversion of a single slider crank mechanism. Next, we will move on to the second inversion of a single slider crank mechanism. And this is one of the example or the inversion of a second inversion of a single slider crank mechanism. That is rotary engine. This one is the rotary engine. Here the number of cylinders are fixed along the circumference of that. Okay, then here There is a common crank here. This is a common crank for all the cylinders. This is a common crank and this is the connecting rod. Okay, here this one is a connecting rod. This is a crank, fixed crank. Here we are fixing the crank. Okay, earlier in the first inversion the cylinder was fixed. In this inversion the crank is fixed. This crank is fixed in this. And here the piston, all the these pistons that are connected to the common crank. Here in a rotary engine the slider is replaced by a piston. Here the slider is replaced by a piston. And the link, the we will consider that cylinder is a the link one by a cylinder pivoted at this point. Okay, here it is pivoted at this point. And here instead of one cylinder, number of cylinders symmetrically placed, okay, here at regular intervals and equal angle between the two links in the same plane or the parallel planes. Here number of cylinders in the same plane or in the parallel planes, but it is a regular intervals between the two cylinders, and all the cylinders rotate about the same fixed center and form a balanced system. Here the fixed link, here that fixed link 2 is a fixed link. Okay, that link 2 is a fixed link, that is the crank. It is a common crank for all the cylinders. This one, this is a common crank here, that is link 2. The fixed link 2 is common to all cylinders. Okay, in a rotary engine the crank 2 is fixed and this cylinder or the body 1 rotates, whereas a reciprocating engine the body is fixed and the crank rotates. That is the difference between this reciprocating engine and the rotary engine. Here the body is fixed, here the crank is fixed. Okay, depends on the application we will change the fixedness of the link in a mechanism, that we will call it as an inversion. This is one of the inversion of a single slider crank mechanism. Okay, next, the third inversion is an oscillating cylinder engine. This is the third inversion of a single slider crank mechanism. Here in the oscillating cylinder engine the link 4, this is the link 4, is made in the form of a cylinder and a piston is fixed to the end of the link 1. Okay, this is the piston, this is the piston rod. Here the piston is placed at the end of this link 1. Okay, and the piston reciprocates in the cylinder. Here this is the cylinder, the piston reciprocates in the inside the cylinder pivoted to the fixed link. Here the connect, this third link 3 is fixed. Okay, connecting rod, this link 3 is fixed. Okay, this arrangement is known as the oscillating cylinder engine. This cylinder will oscillate when the piston is moving inside the cylinder. The piston will oscillate, the cylinder will oscillate. Okay, in the previous example the cylinder is fixed, but here it is oscillating. This cylinder is oscillating, that's why it's called as oscillating cylinder engine. Here the piston reciprocates, the cylinder oscillates and the crank rotates. Okay, these are the different motions. Okay, reciprocating, oscillating and rotating. Okay, these are this is the third inversion of a single slider crank mechanism, because here the link 3 is fixed. Okay, this is fourth inversion of a single slider crank mechanism. You might have seen this hand pump. Okay, we are using this hand pump to lift the underground water. Here we are not using any power, only human effort is required to lift the water. And we have to oscillate this handle. Okay, here there is a handle here. And here the link 4 is fixed. This is the cylinder in the pump. We are that hole which we have drilled to get the water, underground water, and it is fixed. And here that link 1 is connected with the plunger. Okay, here there is a plunger. And in this hand pump, link 4 is made in the form of a cylinder and a plunger is fixed in the link 1 reciprocating in it. Okay, here this plunger will reciprocating in it. And here there is a connecting rod between this and this. And we have to oscillate this handle. Okay, that's why it is called hand pump. Okay, human effort is required to lift the water. Okay, without any power we can lift the water, underground water. And at the same time, if it is for lifting the water, putting the human effort, it will save the water, according to me, because we have to put more effort to lift the water. Okay, for that we will not waste the water. If it is a power driven, they definitely we will waste the water. Okay, these are some of the inversions of single slider crank mechanism. Next we will move on to the inversions of double slider crank mechanism.